Personal finance. What is personal finance? The finance which you manage at house on a day-to-day basis and on a month-to-month basis is what is called personal finance. Now, why this is very important? It has become very, very complicated to track our expenses and the money outgo. That is why this is very, very much important. If you try to recollect, our transactions on a day-to-day basis have increased by leaps and bounds. And for a month, it has become unimaginable. So unless you really track these expenses, you will not be able to discover where exactly your expenses are going, which pockets it's landing in. And you will not be able to review where you can cut short your expenses, where you can save your money. Remember one thing. Cut shorting your expenses is another form of saving. Just like, you know, energy saved is energy generated. Similarly, expenses reduced is savings increased. So make a record of all the expenses you're doing, all the income that you receive in an Excel sheet, which is very handy for all of us because we are all in the computer world. If you're not very computer savvy, or if you're not very comfortable with handling these transactions in a computer, take out a notebook and try to write down on a day-to-day basis what your personal finances handlings are. Where is the money going out? Where is the money coming in? List out all the things. It will be very, very useful for you. And you categorize these expenses when you are writing it, because that is where you will know when you are reviewing where the chunk of money is actually going off. Okay? Review this once a week. Make it a habit. On Saturday and Sunday, we spend our money for a lot many things. But try to devote this, say for example, half an hour for this analysis of where your money is going. And then make it a point to review at the month end where your money is exactly landing in. Very, very important. Then the next step is compare this with your previous month's expenditure. Then when you are comparing with previous month's expenditure, you will really realize what additional expenditure you have incurred in this month. Right? This is a very important aspect. Then this will go into your self-realization and you can take some very good decisions about that. Number two in personal finance is note your investments. See, we all do investments in our career all lifelong. Right from the age of, say, 21, 22, we start investing till the age of 60. Because this spans to about 40 years virtually, whatever investments we are making, as we get busier in life, in our work life, in our personal life, we tend to actually miss out certain investments. I know a person in my father's office who had made huge investments in real estates, in flats, in golds, in bank fixed deposits and all other stuff. But when he died, he never tracked it and written it in a notebook. His children could not take all the investments which he has invested. So the end object of investing all these things has become a waste. When your investments are not going to be useful either for you or for your children, it is a waste of time, effort and money for you to save the investment. So make a note of all the investments you have. Let it be your liquid assets or your fixed assets. Write down systematically where you have invested, how much money you have invested, when is it you have invested, when is it going to mature, who is a proper person for you or for your son and daughter to contact when that money matures. And write down the contact details like phone number, location, branch number, bank name, and if possible, the FP or the investment distinctive number for tracking. Okay. At the same time, you also note the liabilities, because what liabilities you're having, you may not divulge with your wife or children, but you need to note it. For example, bank EMI, gold loan or personal loan or credit card loan or whatever loan, car loan you had purchased. Make a note of all these things in a diary and make it very, very systematic so that it is easier to read and easier to understand. If this is not going to happen, your children are really going to suffer in long term. That is for sure. Let us go to the next one. Update your beneficiary. One of the most important aspects, my dear friends, which we forget in our personal finances, is updating our beneficiary name. We go on investing amount, but suddenly if something happens to us, if we die, you know, who the money will go to? Banks and financial institutions have made it mandatory these days that you need to name a beneficiary, well and good. if they have not made it beneficiary and they have also missed and you have also missed, then your children are going to miss the investments. So make it a point to review your investments. See that wherever you are not allotted a beneficiary, allot it immediately. And wherever you are allotted a person who is not in existence. For example, when we started our career, we used to invest money and nominate our father or mother in that place. Now, as we progress in life, as we grow older, our father and mother would have expired. Now, change your nomination and beneficiary to your wife and children in this aspect, because they should be getting the money in your absence. That is objective. This many people miss out, and you should not miss out, because if you want your money to reach your family, wife and children, you should make this. Okay? Now, the next thing which is important is inform to one of the family members whatever investments you had made, whatever amount you have invested, where you have invested, you should let it know to your wife or to your son or to your daughter, whoever is elder and whoever is able to understand this investment. Unless you tell this, nobody is going to remember this in this world. All the hard efforts you have made during your lifetime for accumulating these assets and saving this money will go a waste if you don't tell one person to track it and to get the investments after us. This is very important. You can choose your wife if she is knowledgeable and interested. You can choose your son or daughter if they have come to age, so that they know what to do after us. If you are there, well and good. But if the investments are going to mature beyond a certain point of time where we are not sure that we are going to be living, then you should be informing to one of your family members for sure. I've told you an example where the children have lost their money because the parents or the father has not informed about this investments. This is a very big loss. Who will ultimately enjoy the money? The banks are going to invest. The banks are going to enjoy the money. So if you want your investments to reach the right recipient or the beneficiary, inform to one of the family members without fail. Okay. The next thing is, in your banking operations, there is a facility that either you can operate the account or your joint owner can operate the account. There is a facility called either or survivor, E or S. Try to enable it at the earliest, because if something happens to you, the investment should not be locked from being operated. The joint holder, either your wife or your son or your daughter, should be able to access the account, operate the account in your absence without providing any title or legal testimony for that. Don't make it inconvenient for them to handle your finance. It is for you to make their life easy. Okay, so if you've not done this, either or survivor is an option for operating the type of operating the account in bank. Do that immediately, which will be very helpful. The next one is, we might have opened multiple bank accounts during our phase of work life. We might be changing jobs, we might be going to different cities for working, we might be going to various places, we might be opening the bank accounts for various purposes. But when you finally reach, 45 or 50, reduce your complications of having multiple bank accounts. The disadvantages are many rather than advantages. The disadvantages are, you will not be able to maintain minimum balance to all the banks which has increased the minimum balance right now. It is, you are only going to feed money to the bank, nothing else. The second thing is, you will not be able to track what money is coming into each of your bank account on a regular basis. Number three, you will not be able to maintain the passwords and the user IDs of all the banks which you are presently holding. So why do you want to have complicated investment portfolio, and why do you want to operate in a very complicated way? All the passwords these days which is provided the bank is hardly valid for about 1 month, after which you have to change it, otherwise they will expire. So for this not to happen, reduce your bank accounts to one or maximum two. You can plan it this way: one account should be for your money coming into the bank account, the other could be your current bank account for all expenses, transactions and other things. So plan it that way according to your convenience, but don't have more than two bank accounts. It's highly impossible for you to manage, and this is not going to help you in the long run. The sixth and the most important thing is, this is for people who are advancing in age for beyond 45 or 50. If you have assets, various types of assets which you have built, like gold, like real estates, like flats, like investment in you know, foreign currencies, then investments in shares, debentures, then investment in various other forms of investments, like so many other things are there, like Bitcoin, other things. Now you try to liquidate all these things and put it in one bank account for everybody's soul. After 50, or rather after 55, age is not guaranteed, life is not guaranteed. When your sons come to age to realize the investments what you have made, it will be very complicated, my dear friends, because the amount of hard work you have taken in creating these assets, okay, in creating or in building a flat or purchasing a land, then regularizing it with title and safeguarding it all these years without encroachment, goals which you have purchased and kept in the bank lockers, all these things you have made the hard work. Now the next generation will not realize this. If they are earning sufficiently present at present, they will not even care about your investments. They will afford to lose it rather than trying to make it streamlined with a clear title of descendants. So for you to safely pass on these investments to your next generation, liquidate all your assets which you have built at the age of 50 or 55 and see that they are in one bank as money which can be used across all terms or conditions of medium of finance, so that children or your wife can immediately withdraw money for their immediate need and use it. Don't keep it in so many types of investments like what you have been managing. You have been managing very well, that is because you have created the wealth. Your children will not be having time to safeguard your different types of investments. So try to liquidate all these things and see that you have liquidated cash for handling of spouse and children. Let us go to the next one. Books of investment proof. I think I have touched this topic a little before. Maintain a file or a folder where you have all the investments proof, like FD receipts, bank titles, legal papers, and other things which are the evidences of your assets which you have created. Because if this is one place, neither you have to search it nor your descendants have to search it. This will make them very, very clear and proper for them to handle your finance after your age. This is very important, my dear friends. In this, you can always have your checkbook, passbook, FD receipts, bonds, post office books, contact persons, addresses, phone numbers, institutions' names, branches, etc., etc., at one place. So this will be a one recorder in the nutshell. The next one is review all your investments once in a quarter at least, because in once in a quarter, some of your investments might mature. Some of your investments may need to have some changes made. Banks may change the app. Bank may change some types of investments you have. They may some banks may merge and like to have your investment proofs changed in that matter. So there may be a lot of changes. You also might be recollecting that some of the investments need not be continued. So have a review of all your investments once in a quarter so that you can reduce complexity and make your life simple. The next one is open an app. These days, if you are comfortable in making maintaining these investments and proofs through a physical format like a notebook, well and good. It is up to your patience. But the easier way of doing this is an app. Now, so many apps have come where your personal finances can be maintained regularly. It will give you alarm. It will give you notifications about whatever you are maintaining. There is also called a safe locker, digital safe locker, which also can maintain all the things. So try to make use of the technology which has developed in an advanced way and see that your complications, life is made easy for you to maintain your assets and investments. At the same time, when you are doing this, there are so many mobile apps which are very, very easy to handle. It's only our mental block that we don't try to use mobile banking or online facility of banks and other things. This will reduce your physical stress a lot. Believe me, that mobile apps are the best which has been the invention from the banking. Now, try to make use of these facilities. See that you lessen your complication, simplify your transaction procedure, and see that the memory is retained by a different person other than the human brain, because human brain's memory can never be trusted. Okay. Now, the last but not the least, all this management of personal finances is an art. Think that it's a management. The way you manage, that's an art. and pass on this art of managing finance in a very principled and a very, very clean manner so that your next generation appreciates it and follow your footsteps in that. You know, have that regularly written, review that once in a week, once in a month, then try to analyze where your money has gone, how to make it more simple, how to make it more remunerative. All these things, try to create an art of management in this so that your next generation emulates your principles and they also reach the rich benefits whatever you have laid the foundation for. Okay, with this I'll try to stop. One good sentence which I would like to tell you is, make your life easy for yourself, make it easy for others, make them enjoy handling finance. Teach them how to handle finance, because this is not being taught in the school. Okay, teach them how to handle finance and see that they appreciate your hard-earned efforts of creating the asset, and try to make them maintain that after your age is over. Okay, with these few words, I conclude. If you like this session, hit the subscribe button and the bell button for regularly getting notifications about finance, motivation and other videos I promote. Thank you. Bye.